This is a multi-part video series to show you how to build real-time apps with serverless technology. And we're going to build a full-stack, real-time, serverless app with zero dependencies. I know, right? All of the buzzwords. But I'm really excited about this because it's my goal to show you how easy it is to build any stateful serverless app with durable objects. Don't worry if you don't know what that is, we'll talk about it much later. So here's what we're going to build. Let's switch over to my screen so that I can show you this. We're going to be building a video calling app called Vit. So it's live right now and it's accessible on vit.pages.dev. And you can go on to create a new call. So let's create a new meeting. And if it's your first time, you have to give it permissions to use your camera and microphone so we can allow this. And here we have our video calling app going. Now, it's not all fun if it's just one pair in the call. So let's join from a different client. I'm going to mute the mic here so that when we go join, we don't have that weird interruption. And what I'll do is I'm going to go copy this call URL. Let's go to vit.pages.dev. And this could be on a different device, on a different computer, somewhere else in the other part of the world. And we can paste this link to join the call. So let's join the call. And here we have two clients connected to the exact same call. And this is really awesome. So I have a little preview of what my video looks like. And I have a bigger video of the other calling client. And of course, if we head back to the first client, you notice it is exactly the same view we have here. So this is really awesome. And the exciting part about this is that everything you're seeing here is handled purely with serverless tech. So let's take a look at the architecture of this application so that you see what this looks like. So I'm going to create a new tab. And this is what it is. I'm just going to open up this quick file. And this is everything you're seeing. Something you notice right off the bat is that this looks really, really simple. So we have two clients, which is the first client you saw, the first calling party and the answering party, and both are connected together using the same durable object. So you have a worker sitting in front of the durable object to route both clients, since they are on the same call, to the same durable object. And then using WebSocket, they figure out the best way to connect to each other using WebRTC. So the durable object is coordinating the WebSocket connection. And when they figure out the best way to connect over WebRTC, they can directly start sending the media stream over to each other. So they can send the video stream, the audio stream, and they're able to see and hear each other on the call. So this is what we're going to be building in this series. And it is really awesome. And if you love to take a look at the code and follow along as we build the project, here's a link to the GitHub repository to set up this project locally. In the next video, we'll dive deeper into the secret sauce of building this app. I know I already said it a couple of times already, so it's probably not so secret. It's durable objects, and we'll begin coding this application together. Don't forget to get subscribed so that you don't miss the next video in this series. And let me know if you found this interesting by leaving a like. My name is Confidence, and I'm going to see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.